And once you understand that this principle, all of these agonizing types of warm-ups that you've been put on by a lot of teachers over the years, you'll find that you don't have to necessarily do those. If you do this thing, the fluttering, until you get, hey, that feels pretty good. Then if you want to do a little, just to check it out a little, right? And that's what I might do, is I might check it out a little, see how it works. I got to get through this concert. Well, I'm the guy out front. I'm not just sitting in the band. I'm not in the section. I'm the standing out in front of the band. I'm like the featured artist or something. So like everybody is like, I can't hide in the section and clam my little note, and be covered. Everybody's going to be noticing. So what I do is I'll play something, and while the band's playing another little thing, I'll act like it's hot on stage and do this. And because I don't believe in standing on a stage and going to the audience. You know, I don't have to explain all this to them. But if I stand and do this, now all I need is 10 or so seconds. And I can pump enough blood back in there that when I come back here, I pick up the horn, some of the soreness has gone away, and I say, yeah, bless, and they say, okay, let's get it. That trumpet's not that thing where it says in the stand, don't worry about what does it say? You got two options. You can either diminuendo the thing normally, or you can kind of go into the stand, but you do both in this pitch. Okay. The diminuendo reduces it, and you can reduce it again by going into the stand, the thing is like the trumpet. So the one or the other, right? Here we go. One, two.